falling breaking news tonight out of Burnsville. Police say a man took workers hostage at a Holiday gas station earlier tonight. This was the scene from our traffic management cameras around 6 o'clock. You can see a group of officers and canines on the scene there.
Gas station is at the intersection of Highway 13 and Nicolette Avenue near 35W. 5 Eyewitness News reporter Steve Tellier is live at the scene tonight with the latest. Steve?
Tom, we were able to confirm new information with police just about 90 minutes ago. They tell us a suspect is in custody tonight after he tried to rob the Holiday gas station behind me and took two workers inside hostage. This happened right around 6 o'clock is when it started, again at the intersection of Highway 13 and Nicolette Ave in Burnsville. Police say that man was armed with a shotgun when he stormed into the gas station and took two employees hostage. Our cameras were there as heavily armed officers surrounded the gas station. Police tell us the suspect did fire one shot into the ceiling of that gas station, but an officer actually got the suspect on the phone and somehow convinced him to surrender peacefully. The hostages were released unharmed. And we saw that suspect handcuffed and taken into custody just a few hours ago. Shortly after that happened, a bomb squad from Bloomington had to be called in because they found a suspicious package in the parking lot of that gas station. But that package was deemed not a threat after a short period of time. It actually may not be connected to the hostage standoff at all. Now, we spoke with a witness who pulled into the gas station just as that standoff began.
We couldn't see anything other than there were cars parked at pumps and in front of the station. So I decided to go, and then four cop cars came driving around the corner right at that moment that I was getting out of there. And then there started to be all kinds of cops showing up from all over the place. So
police have not yet released the name of that suspect or any other identifying information. We also don't have any information on formal charges just yet. What we do know is that there are two former hostages tonight who are quite thankful for at least one Burnsville police officer who was able to successfully arrange for them to be released unharmed. Live in Burnsville, I'm Steve Tellier, 5 Eyewitness News.
And now to some headlines.